Welcome to the Big Fat Quiz of the Year. This is the show that deals with all the most important stories of the last 12 months. Except that one. No, we won't focus on all the bloodshed, hatred and raging conflict. That wouldn't be fair to Holly or Phil. Let's meet our teams. Two amazing, hilarious guests cancelled at the last minute. But to replace them, we've managed to get Richard Iowati and Mel Gedreich. Yeah. Next up, a brave woman who's had to endure several painful operations in order to overcome her physical challenges, and a comedian with cerebral palsy. It's Rosie Jones of Dazzle 9. Next up, lock up your daughters, it's Mo Gilligan, and whilst you're there, maybe lock up your drinks cabinet, it's Kevin Bridges. Mo and Kevin, everyone. Have you got sort of team names, Richard, Mel?
Oh, sorry.
Yes,
we were
sorry.
Just chatting.
We were just chatting.
I've suddenly realised I've still got my coat on.
Mel, you look good with a coat, man.
Do you like it?
You look like a mum at parents' evening.
OK. Mo, shall I go collar up?
Put a collar up.
Yeah.
You look like a Bond villain.
Yeah? Yeah.
That's good, man.
But I don't want you to feel like I want to leave.
I don't feel, don't worry.
OK.
What is the team name going to be?
I thought the Unpronounceables. It's difficult to know whether you're allowed to laugh at it because that might make you slightly prejudiced.
I think the Unpronounceables is good, yeah.
I like it.
Catherine, Rosie, have you got a team name?
Rosie and I are very close.
Yeah.
And I feel like we're going to make a great team.
Oh, yeah.
We both like to drink and it is the holidays. I was thinking, like, the alcoholidays.
I hate that.
Oh. Here are my other winner. He sees you when you're drinking. Santa's besties, simple, or the classic Daddy and Me.
Oh, I like that because Daddy and Daddy.
Daddy.
OK, well, let's go with a slightly creepy one. Great. Mo, Kevin, have you got a team name?
You've got to say Daddy and Me every time you go to the...
That's not great, is it?
Give it
Daddy
a try.
And Me, what have you got? Mo, Kevin, have you got a team name?
We're going to call ourselves Extinction Rebellion.
I thought we was going to go with GB News.
Well,
because I'm Gilligan, he's Bridges, and GB News, and there ain't no working class black people on the show, so we thought we'd be the representation for GB News.
Or Team GB?
Okay, I think.
But then
GB.
People are going to tune in halfway through and see that and think we're a couple of geeks.
We got that covered over here. Don't worry, you're fine.
Team GB, or third choice name?
Third choice name, yeah.
Wow, we're being suppressed, man.
Nice. Now, the big social media trend this year was everyone using AI to sort of imagine what they would have looked like in the 90s in a yearbook photo. Mo, you did this.
Yeah.
I've got yours. Look at this.
Oh, man.
Oh, wow.
Well, the one in the middle, you look as if you're about to party like it's 1999. It's extraordinary.
The Foss one, that's the GB News.
No, I've done these for everyone. So, Catherine, have a look.
Oh, I like that.
You look like your own hot mum.
You look colder there than you do now.
That's the idea, Rosie.
Rosie, here's yours.
Oh.
I think here, from left to right, it's like from grade A student to she joined a gang. Mel, here's you.
Oh, dear.
Ooh.
Yeah. I know. I know. It's a lot.
The hip hop one.
Yeah.
If you look like that in the 90s, no wonder Sue wanted to work with you.
Guys, I've never felt so great about myself.
Which one of these was most like your teenage self, Mel?
Oh, gang. I used to wear a trilby.
Yes, you did.
I had a corsage, a sort of rose corsage on my lapel.
Were you a detective?
I want to live in AI, man, solidly. Yeah. I'm really happy with that.
OK, Richard, here's yours.
Oh, come on.
Oh,
lovely. Yeah, pretty good.
What I like is that I still look tired.
Yeah. Kevin, they've spent billions of dollars on AI technology. And even with that, they couldn't make you look cool. Have a look. billions. Billions, Kevin. Billions spent.
Yeah, that's strong.
I think the first one looks all right. That's just like something you'd see like, on the wall in a bar in Boston or something, isn't it? Like a on famous a, local yeah. fighter or something.
The middle one looks like he's a streetwise golfer who doesn't play by the rules.
He's trying to come back after he fatally broke his middle finger. Probably flipping someone off.
All right, let's get on with the show. Our first round is all about 2023's biggest headlines. In June, horny cabbage patch doll Boris Johnson resigned as an MP. I assume to spend more time with his families. Essentially, Boris Johnson treated the country like every lover he's ever had, screwed it and then left. In June, Harry, the ginger, formerly known as Prince, became the first British royal to give evidence in court for 130 years. It's disgusting the way the press have tried to manipulate, gaslight and control Harry. I mean, who do they think they are? Meghan? All right, who's up for some questions? Headlines questions first, all right. Question one in the Big Fat Quiz of the Year, 2023. During the COVID inquiry, Dominic Cummings revealed staff at number 10 had a nickname for Boris Johnson. What was it?
Oh, yeah.
OK, good. Yes, please.
Yeah, yeah.
No, I don't know.
I don't know.
I'll give you a clue. It referred to his tendency to change direction.
Oh, yeah! Is that oh, my God!
It was something...
What is it, Daddy? Okay. All right, question number two. In August, former US President Donald Trump posted on Twitter, now X, for the first time in 2 years. Can you tell me what he posted?
What is X? What's that?
Well, there was a thing called Twitter, Nana, and... and Twitter got bought by a man called Elon Musk, who's a bit like Iron Man.
OK.
And then he changed the name to X.
OK. So it's now called X.
It's now called X.
You ever met Elon Musk, Jimmy?
Yeah, of course.
Have you, honestly?
Yeah.
Some lizard party or something, but...
I hope they were gonna hit, didn't they?
Yeah, I mean... We played a game of, you know the game, kind of mafia, like wink murder?
Hang on, you were at a party. How did you get in?
Of course, it wouldn't be the Big Fat Quiz without an appearance from the children of Mitchell Brook Primary School performing one of their unconventional school plays. Please, take a look.
Lovely.
Yeah.
That was great.
All right, so that was, of course, Charles and Camilla's coronation back in May. But what I want to know is why this man, who was in attendance, went viral. Okay. Why did that man go viral?
Mel's actually shadowing this man as part of a case.
He looks like a bunch of kids in a coat, you know, standing on each other's shoulders. Like, you're just trying
Stop
to buy
it.
A cigarette.
Stop it, this poor man.
Hang on, guys. Is he a man?
Yeah!
Okay, take a look at this US news clip in which Montana resident Chase Doak discusses being the first to witness a huge news story of 2023. All I want to know is, what's he talking about?
It was just right here. I mean, I was literally right in this vicinity in my driveway. I had posted a couple of photos just to social media, just joking, like, I thought I saw a UFO. Standing here, I can feel my phone vibrating because people are trying to call me.
Where is this?
Well, it's in Montana. What? You remember what I just said? Montana resident. That was really the clue there.
Sorry, I just
as
got
to
confused.
The location.
He's seen something, didn't he?
He's seen something.
In the air, flying. We've got it.
Look who's paying attention. You know you're in trouble when Kevin Bridges is the star pupil. Oh. All right, last one in this round. In October, the Labour Party started selling T-shirts with a slogan, Sparkle with Starmer, printed on them. Why? Why would they do that?
Why?
All right, you ready for answers? You're ready for answers. Cool,
so
you are.
Ready, so
first
ready.
First up, I asked you if you knew the nickname Dominic Cummings revealed staff at number 10 had given Boris Johnson. Well, what did you put? Let's go through these. Richard, Mel?
Well, I put the main asshole.
And you went for?
Well, I... Slightly boring. I think I might have gone for the right answer.
Yeah.
Trolley.
Oh!
Oh, shit!
Right.
That is it.
Trolley.
Well, I don't want to ruin the Jeopardy, but, yeah, that is it. Yeah, that, I mean, that's... Trolley is the right answer, because he was yeah. all over the place. Well, let's check in. Rosie, Catherine, what did you go for?
You like the widow maker.
The widow maker?
I thought I remember Foot Pig.
Oh, you're dangerously close with... But it's a related thing, but trolley is the right answer. Mo, Kevin, what do you put?
We put the trolley as well, man. Because I remember reading it at the time, and I was like, how did... As if they know what a wonky shopping trolley is like, Tory. They're Waitrose home delivery, man. They've never...
They call him the trolley because, like, a supermarket trolley, he changed directions. And apparently supermarket trolleys do that. I've not been to a supermarket, but I hear they're lovely. Cummings also revealed he had a nickname for Boris's cabinet at the time, which was useless fuck pigs.
Technically, Boris Johnson is in the cabinet.
Yeah.
Whoa! Mic drop. He's one of the useless fuck pigs, isn't he?
Yeah.
Because it's Christmas, you get a point.
Yeah. Come
on. Yeah. All right, you all get points. I asked you what Donald Trump tweeted after his 2-year absence from Twitter. What did you all put?
I think he said something along the lines of never submit.
Ooh.
To your own heart. But he just put never submit. Or the other thing was...
I thought he said something like, four indictments, boom, or something like that.
Sorry, do that again, because something happened with your voice.
Four indictments, boom. It's a soft mouth, isn't it? Four indictments, boom. Yes. That's it. We've got it now. We've nailed it. Four indictments, boom.
It's so good.
Something like that, because of his indictments, and then he just...
Not enough people do impressions anymore.
OK, Rosie, Catherine, what did you put?
Well, we're not on X, so no. I just thought he unveiled a hashtag Trump2024 because he never gives up.
All right, Mo, Kevin, what do you think?
It was a link to his OnlyFans page, wasn't it? Like, his own... like, his own social media site, wasn't it? It was something... He was promoting something, anyway.
Well, no, I'm surprised no one got this. I'll show you what he tweeted. There it is.
Hang on, never surrender.
It was the mugshot. We were looking for the mugshot.
Oh.
And then they started selling Never Surrender merchandise, which was ironic because he had surrendered to a police station to get that photo taken, so... All right, next I asked you why this man went viral at the King's coronation. Mo, Kevin, what did you put?
We put it was at one of your parties.
Catherine, Rosie, what did you think?
I mean, again, we were split. I think maybe he fell asleep. What an amazing moment to be in the audience for that, but he just fell asleep. Yeah. And Rosie...
And I think it's Judy Finnegan. In a mustache.
Is it Judy Finnegan?
It is not Judy Finnegan, but you're along the right lines. Let's go live to Mel Gedroych.
I think he might have had something to do with the music of the show.
And
they thought he was in disguise, so everyone was saying, oh, who is it in disguise? Lols, is it Meghan Markle in disguise? Wasn't it something to do with that? It was a sort of lolsy on the media social platform.
Like the film White Chicks.
So people on social media thought it might be Meghan Markle in disguise. It was, in fact, Sir Carl Jenkins, and he's a composer. He wrote a piece of music for the ceremony. Yeah. I asked you what Montana resident Chase Doak was talking about. What did you put?
The big balloon. They thought it was a chick. Well, I don't know. I think it was a Chinese spy balloon. Remember?
Yeah.
Oh! Write that.
You can't write it now. Rosie, what did you write?
A big balloon.
What did you write?
A big bird flying. A big bird.
You think you saw a big bird and that made the news? I saw a big bird.
Well, it's in America. American rabbit, their boots are like really big.
And have you seen Sesame Street? Hang on, what happened to Big Bird? Are you wearing him? Okay, so Big Bird, what did you guys get for this? Richard, Mel?
I put the new host of This Morning.
You thought he saw the new host of This Morning flying overhead?
It would make the news, wouldn't it?
I mean, that's inarguable. It was, of course, the Chinese spy balloon. I asked you why Labour started selling Sparkle with Starmer T-shirts. What did you all put?
We put, why not?
Great answer.
Why not?
Why not?
There was a protester threw glitter on him. That is true, though, isn't it?
Yeah, they glitter-bombed him. You've got a picture. So that guy, he was going for electoral reform, like a change to the voting system.
Have you ever had glitter in your eye?
Yeah.
It's very dangerous. Very dangerous. It can turn you gay.
One little bit.
Yeah. What did you put for this?
No ads, Paul.
I put glitter bomb.
You put glitter bomb.
Glitter bomb at the Labour Party conference. Yeah.
OK. All right, well, let's see what that's done to the scores. Rosie, Catherine, you have 1 point so far. Richard, Mel, Mo, Kevin, you've both got three.
Three?
Yeah. OK, all right.
All right. Hang on.
Time for a break now. But just like David Cameron, we'll be back to annoy you again in a bit. See you in five. Welcome back to the Big Fat Quiz of 2023. Our next round is all about music. In October, Liam Gallagher recorded announcements for Manchester's tram network. Manchester's Metrolink has 8 lines, much like Liam did every morning before breakfast in the 90s. Girls Aloud reformed after an 11-year hiatus, but the girls say they will not be releasing any new music. So, it's not all bad news. All right, questions on music. For our first question, it's over to self-esteem.
Ooh. Hi, Jimmy. You know me, I'm always banging on about women and female empowerment and all that, so I was delighted to see Ariana DeBose's BAFTA rap back in February, celebrating all the women in the room. She went viral for her lyrics, complimenting the likes of Jamie Lee Curtis and Cate Blanchett. But what line did she use to compliment Angela Bassett that confused viewers?
OK, so self-esteem wants to know what lyrics Ariana DeBose rapped about Angela Bassett at the BAFTAs that confused everyone. She did a rap about all the ladies there.
Is this it?
Okay, why did this fairly mundane Instagram story from pop superstar Dua Lipa showing her cooking for her friends and fam make headlines back in June?
That looks rough, doesn't it? What is that supposed to...
Those are vegetables, Kevin.
Oh, my God, we have got this!
OK, American rapper and singer Doja Cat stole the show at the Met Gala back in May. Honouring the Karl Lagerfeld theme, she arrived dressed as a cat. But can you tell me what weird thing she did during her interview with Vogue on the red carpet?
This is a wind-up, this round.
What?
I don't think... Who is this?
That's Doja Cat.
What is this? What's the title of this round? Music?
Yeah, music,
Who the fuck is that? Do you know Doja Cat?
Yeah, I know
Doja Cat.
What kind of genre of music is that?
It's just like pop. But there's nothing funny than you saying Doja Cat. That's the funniest thing I've ever heard. Say it again.
Say it again. I'll say it until I find out who she is. Who the fuck is Doja Cat?
If you want to achieve that look, I've just been working on it over here. You just go like this.
You know what you look like? You see the Grinch? You know the people that...
Yeah, Whoville! Yeah! Whoville!
You look like...
Grinch!
Yeah. You look like one of them!
Well, now it feels like Christmas. OK. For our next question, it's over to Anyone But You star Sydney Sweeney and Glenn Powell.
Hi, Jimmy. In our new movie, Anyone But You, we look like the perfect couple, but it's not exactly a love story.
No. But speaking of love stories, I do have a lot of love for Taylor Swift.
Not as much as one of her fans who is on the news skipping work to queue for exclusive merchandise.
Her interview went viral, but can your teams tell us what disguise she was wearing so that her bosses couldn't recognize her?
Hang on. Oh! Blanket.
Speak up, Mel. A lot of the other teams didn't hear you. So, whoa. What are you doing on your phone?
My teenager is a big fan of Rosie and just wanted to say hello.
Hello!
You? We're really good by it. Do you remember how funny it was when that wet Taylor Swift bunked off work to queue for tickets?
You said Taylor Swift. You said Taylor Swift, I'm listening.
Do you remember?
Are you asking your daughter?
No. She just called me. I'm a mother. I have to answer the phone. Is anyone hurt? So what did she dress like when she bunked off work?
What are you saying?
What?
Hang up the phone, Catherine.
This is your fault. You're going to state school. Goodbye.
All right, next question. Pop icon Madonna embarked on a world tour this year. In November, she confused the crowd in Germany by asking them to collectively do something on the count of three. What did Madonna ask the Germans to do?
Okay. Oh.
All right, you all got something? Yeah, Catherine, Rosie?
Yeah, we got something.
All right, you got something, all right. All right, so, question one. Self-esteem asked you what line Ariana DeBose rapped about Angela Bassett that confused the BAFTA viewers. What did you all get? Richard, Mel?
It was something along the lines of... I don't know why I'm looking up at that angle. That's really weird. Yeah. Help me down again.
Because you're remembering.
There we go. It was something along the lines of, what the hell is she doing here? Or something. Yeah. It was a bit mean.
It was as much like Columbo as you made it sound. But we thought maybe it was reverse engineered from something like Facets. Or she has multiple facets. It's Angela Bassett. I think we don't know.
That's it. We could have saved ourselves a lot of bother. OK. Mo, Kevin, did you get this?
I thought she might have said, big up Tina Blood Clark Turner, because she played Tina Turner.
No. Catherine, Rosie, what did you put?
This I know. Angela Bassett did the thing.
That's spoken like someone that watched this a million times.
So bizarre.
Yeah.
What did she say?
Angela Bassett did the thing.
I mean, it's an energetic and enthusiastic performance. I'd be amazed if you get through this without having to look away cringing.
Good luck, everyone.
Oh.
All the ladies in the room, supporting and leading, all here, I presume. Hong Chao, Dolly D, Carrie and Carrie with the C. Dame Emma, I'm so fond. Anna girl, you were great and blonde. Danielle D, you broke my heart. Michelle, I've loved you from the start. Angela Bassett did the thing. Viola Davis, my woman king. Blanche Kate, you're a genius. And Jamie Lee, you are all of us.
Oh, God.
So, I suppose rap's over now, is it?
Yeah.
That's what Doja Cat sounds like, basically.
Yeah. OK, Angela Bassett did the thing.
Did the thing is the right answer.
I asked why this mundane Dua Lipa post made headlines back in June. What did you all think?
I didn't think she cooked it. I think someone else made it and she made that it was hers.
Okay.
And then I said, did somebody say, just eat? I thought that was...
If you were over at Dua Lipa's and that's what she cooked, you'd make your excuses, man. Just leave.
You would leave Dua Lipa's house if she served that?
100%, mate. It's a massive red flag, innit, if that...
Catherine, Rosie, what did you get for this?
I think it's... when Elton John was performing at Glastonbury and everyone thought she was going to come out and perform with him, but she was like, now I'm busy eating green shit. Yeah.
Well, she's very busy because he had to cook that and then she had to do some chips for Kev.
Yeah.
Mel, Richard, did you get this?
We did.
At Glasto.
During Elton at Glasto, she was supposed to be there.
Yeah.
Yeah. So Elton said during the show, the person I did this song with isn't here, so I'm going to ask you to sing her part. Please sing it loudly. Look at that. Fabulous. All right. Next, I asked you what Doja Cat, as it will now be pronounced, what Doja Cat did at the Met Gala. What did you write? What did you think?
Wasn't she like purring, acting like a cat?
He's done
like this?
All the heavy lifting in this round. This has passed right over my head, the whole thing.
Okay, so purring like a cat. Catherine, Rosie?
We didn't notice her, and guessing she licked her own arsehole.
Mel, Richard?
She did meow meow, I think.
And then urinated in cat litter.
Point. No point. Point. Well, let's take a look at the bizarre and unique interview. Here it is.
Wow. Okay, so something a little different. So, what was your inspiration for tonight? Be honest with me and go into detail.
Wow. Wow. Wow.
So, what are you excited to see in there today?
Wow.
Is it your first Met?
Wow.
I'll see you in there.
Wow.
It really takes the edge off climate change, stuff like that.
The world is ending, but...
I know. What kind of future are we leaving for our kids? What kind of kids are we leaving for the future? Maybe the planet wants to die. That is unacceptable, oh. Man. Yeah.
All right, so Sydney Sweeney and Glenn Powell asked what disguise a Taylor Swift fan wore to avoid being recognised. What did you all put?
We think he dressed as the Coronation Man.
Rosie Catherine, what did you get?
I think she hid under a blanket.
Yeah.
OK, Mel, Richard?
Chinua Achebe.
What, sorry?
He won the Nobel Prize. He wrote Things Fall Apart really good.
Oh, you're so close.
It's a good disguise.
So close, because you're sitting next to them and they got it right. Yeah.
Hang on, I gave them the answer.
Yeah. Well, why did you write it?
Oh, hang on, she did write it.
She did write it next.
Points, points, no points. Have a look.
But we have a special surprise for you guys. There are two Swifties here who shall remain anonymous, who called in sick to work.
That's exactly how he looks. That's what he looks like.
Well, you get the point for blanket, so well done. I asked you what Madonna asked an audience in Germany to do. What did you put?
We put just that Vogue. 1, 2, 3. Because I saw her daughter voguing, 11 years old. It's like amazing at it.
Richard.
Retrain as dentists.
On the count of three, everyone.
Retrain as dentists.
What did you get for this?
Fart.
Mo, Kevin?
We said fart as well.
No.
Fart as well, man.
Well, let's have a look at this unique and rather remarkable request.
I hear you like fart jokes. Is that true? You like fart jokes? So if I count to three, could you all fart on cue? No, I'm serious. Okay. I'm gonna count to three. If you can make yourself fart, I want you to do it. Don't shit on anybody. One, two, three. That's not a fart, no.
That's when you have a bet with someone about, you can't fucking make them all fart. You watch this.
Well, like, and well, if like, I was in the audience, I'd be like, 100 quid a ticket, you fucking fart, Madonna.
OK, now it's time for a special bonus round. This is the part of the show where I introduce a mystery guest. All you need to do is tell me who they are. However, you can only ask them yes or no questions. So please welcome our mystery guests. Look at these. Great to have you here. This is Andrew, Jackie, Annie and Sharon. So you can ask them yes or no questions and write down the answers as soon as you think you know why they made the news.
Are you the next phase of Marvel?
No, it's a very good guess, but this is the music round.
Oh, okay.
Do you work together?
Yes.
Did you perform with a big artist?
Yeah.
Yes. Yes. Yes.
Have
yes.
any of you ever shit yourself at a Madonna concert?
No.
Was the big artist a man?
No.
Was the big artist American?
No.
No.
Was the big artist Kylie Minogue?
Yes.
Wow. Okay, write down your answers. If you haven't got it now, you're not going to get it.
Well, not UK, not American. Yes, Kylie Minogue. That's how I did that.
Did you recreate a famous video?
Yes.
Girl,
if this is the
You got to name the thing. Name the thing that you don't know the name of. Oh, he knows this, but he doesn't. It's in there somewhere.
Yeah.
So Mo, Kevin, what do you think?
So I think they recreated a Kylie Minogue video. We think it's the song Can't Get You Out of My Head.
All right, so Rosie, Catherine?
So we got something to do with Padam Padam.
Mel, Richard, what did you think?
My detective partner has written TikTok how it's meant to be spelt, actually, with two C's.
That's how you spell it, TikTok.
It is.
What song have you written?
They did a TikTok to Padam Padam.
OK, well, who are you and why did you make the news?
We are Hobbycraft colleagues and our TikTok of Kylie Minogue's Padam Padam went viral.
Yeah.
Good. Let's, well, let's take a look. Here they are. So, slow day in Hobbycraft Wimbledon?
We don't have slow days, we work in retail.
Of course.
Don't exist.
What happened there then? There's no one in the store and you're doing a dance. yeah, this is right. And so, did Kylie answer back? Did she see it?
Yes. She, we were really lucky. She duetted with us because she'd seen it and loved it.
Wow.
And then we got to be the special guests on her radio interview.
Oh, wow.
Okay, all right, let's check in on the scores. So, Rosie and Catherine, you've got 5. Mo, Kevin, you've got 5. In the lead, Richard and Mel with 8. Yeah. Wow. Give it up for the Hobbycraft team. Yeah. We're going to have a dance. See you after the break. Sure. Welcome back to the Big Fat Quiz of the Year. Unless you've only just tuned in which case, don't worry, you've not missed much. This round is all about film and TV. In October, Colleen and Wayne Rooney released a documentary about the Agatha Christie trial. The documentary was on Disney Plus, which caused some confusion, as a lot of kids saw Wayne in the trailer and thought there was a new Shrek film. Ready for TV and film questions? Of course you are. All right, back in September, members of the public were bidding thousands of dollars for actors to offer relationship advice, paint watercolors of their dogs, and solve their crosswords. All I want to know is why.
Oh, yes, yes, yeah. Yes, yes.
Fresh from his hit Netflix series, it's over to the legend that is Robbie Williams.
Hey up, Jimmy. I've spent most of the year touring the world, but when I am home, I love a movie night with the kids. Barbie was, of course, one of the biggest movies of the year, and I couldn't help but notice a new term being coined off the back of it. It had celebrities and psychologists attempting to define it. But can your teams tell me what that term was?
OK, so Robbie wants to know what term was coined off the back of the Barbie movie.
Is it time to pull out the Polish handmade cherry brandy?
It is.
That's not a euphemism.
Guys, is there if anyone wants it?
Can I try some?
Handmade by my friend.
I want some.
Love
you. Oh, I have it.
Now,
you're going to wake up in a dumpster.
Right. Rosie, do you want some?
Nice.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Rosie and I would like some, please.
It's very sweet, though.
Oh, yeah, I know, you would imagine.
Jimmy, do you want a little sharpener?
I'm cutting right down on cherry brandy.
Okie dokes.
Jimmy only drinks WD-40.
Nice.
Right, back in March, Gwyneth Paltrow was cleared of all charges in a ski collision trial against a retired optometrist. What iconic parting words did she whisper to her accuser as she left the courtroom?
It was so good and I can't remember. It was so funny.
It is good.
Yeah, it was really passag.
Passive-aggressive, but she's in a super hurry, so... pass out. OK, take a look at this clip of Greg Wallace and Michelle Rue Jr. on Channel 4 in July.
Right. Like a knife through butter, that is. Oh, wow. Mmm. Mmm. That hardly needs chewing.
OK, the programme received hundreds of complaints, with viewers saying it made them feel sick. All I want to know is why. OK, what TV moment of the year prompted these viewer reactions?
Why would they do that? You were my purpose.
There's no way that I'm in the cave.
And I literally had, like, a full, like, emotional... I don't know if it's a breakdown.
What? Okay, what prompted those reactions? You were my purpose.
Yeah.
Why would they do that? This is so much sadder than in the game.
A TV moment made that.
Yeah, a TV moment made that happen. All right, you've all got answers?
Yes.
Yeah, baby.
Okay, Daddy. I asked why members of the public were bidding on experiences with actors. What did you all put?
Slavery cults.
Oh.
No, SAG strike. It was a SAG strike.
Rosie, Catherine.
We put to create income during the SAG strike.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Yeah. And Mo, Kevin?
We put the strike.
Mo forgot how to spell the word strike.
Yeah, I did.
He got it, he nailed it in the end, as you can see.
But this is a modern show, man. Why are we typing it like William Shakespeare? Can't you get like a keyboard or something?
Why are we typing like William Shakespeare? Sorry, you mean.
You mean
writing.
I don't
the
write.
Word you're searching for there is writing. It was the charity auction to support the SAG after strike. Natasha Lyonne, star of Orange is the New Black, raised $6,300 by helping someone with their crossword. John Lithgow painted a dog for $9,700.
Wow.
Good. All right. Robbie Williams asked, what term was coined off the back of the Barbie film? What did you put?
It was a mix of Barbie and...
Oppenheimer or something, but I think he's talking specific to this movie. I thought Barbieheimer was the one about going to see the two movies, wasn't it?
Yeah, but that wasn't...
I understand that, Jimmy. I'm just saying.
That's what I thought it was.
Did you write that?
Yeah, I said Barbie and the other film with the bomb.
The other film.
I didn't know where...
The other film with the bomb.
Yeah. Listen, I'm dyslexic. You think I'm spelling Oppenheimer, brother? You all right? Yeah. Come on, man. Yeah. I could just about spell strike.
Rosie, Catherine, did you get this?
Well... We both watched it. We thought it might be He's Just Ken, because I saw that used a lot of places and memed and...
You're close. Ken's all right. Richard Mell?
White supremacism. And then Kennergy.
Is the right answer.
No way!
It's Kennergy, yeah. It was, of course, Kennergy. I wanted to know what Gwyneth Paltrow's final words were in a court case as she left. What do you think it was?
I'm dying to know.
What did you write?
Good luck to you.
I think it's something like that.
It was.
Too late, yeah. But I think I actually know the answer, but we never wrote it. I think she just says something like, I wish you all the best. But it was
I wish you well. Wish
something. It was quite a nice thing to say, but it was very chilling.
We didn't know, so I said...
It was chilling. It was
awesome. I said, you're on thin ice. I think that would have been cold. That would have been...
That's like a thing Bond says after he's killed him.
Yeah, but that would have been cold, man.
No, I love it.
Yeah.
Richard
Mell? That was no joke. Yeah, that's very nice.
What have you got?
I wish it said, hang tough, big boy. Just because I just... We think it was, I wish you well.
We've written it in the middle.
I wish you well.
I wish you well. I can see it. I wish you well. Well, let's have a look.
This court is now adjourned. Thank you.
Let my client slip out before.
Yes, everyone remains seated while the parties leave.
I'm going to make a quick statement. Ms. Paltrow is not going to be making a statement today.
She said, I wish you well, but it came across as. Okay, next you saw a clip of Greg Wallace and Michelle Rue Jr. eating. Why did it prompt complaints? What did you put?
You've got us, man. It was a mockumentary. And they were pretending to eat people. Like a cannibalism type mockumentary, but people took it serious.
I feel like that's fine.
What, eating human flesh?
Well, yeah, because there's consent involved, presumably. If you're dead and you want your organs to be donated, you can choose that. If you want to be cremated, you can choose that. Maybe you want to be eaten, and you can choose that. And then there's very little waste.
Yeah, I want to go in the green bin.
Okay, but your answer was?
You
meat prank.
How have you made a human meat prank even creepier? Richard Mell?
Anus meats.
Well, I don't know if I could eat a human, but that is definitely where I'd start. Yeah, sure.
and spoof cannibalism.
Okay, so they got 400 Ofcom complaints because people didn't realise it was a hoax documentary. Yep. The British Miracle Meat was about a company that produced human meat for consumption. Okay, I asked you what TV moment of the year upset viewers. What did you all think it was?
Pip Schofield leaving.
Oh. Oh, no, it wasn't.
Based on a video game.
Oh, based on a video game.
Yeah.
We right, also put rewind.
Jimmy Carr live and laughing.
Not the name of any one of my specials.
Well, no one's been laughing.
Curse you. Rosie, Catherine.
Wait, no, it was a latch.
Mo, Kevin?
We put The Last of Us.
Last of Us.
It was The Last of Us. I mean, I wanted episode 3, but I'll give you Last of Us, Last of Us.
Oh, yeah. Good.
Point,
oh,
point,
good.
No point.
What is
it? Okay, it's time now for a special bonus round. I'm going to show you scenes from films released this year which have been subtly improved with an appearance from me.
Oh.
All I want you to do is name that film. First up, here you go.
I'm going to play a little Hendrix.
Wow.
Usually does the trick.
Don't start.
No, I'm starting. Oh, I always liked this tattoo.
So did your brother.
Okay, what film was that from? And I will need the number.
Oh, come on.
You need the number.
You see
him? Fuck.
Did that come out? It did look like both people had had their faces replaced.
You look alright, my new hat.
Well, we'll never know because I bought this. Like a hat you can't take off. OK, what did you write?
Expendables.
It's Expendables.
Is that your...?
I think it might be 4, but I'm not sure. It could be 3.
What?
Hard to say.
What the fuck, man? Is it... Are you put... Is this your real voice?
Mate, this is how I speak when I'm at home. I don't know if it's 4 or could be 3. It's hard to tell.
Really good.
Could be 5. We've been making them for a while.
Is this your own voice? I swear it's my life.
That is his own voice. That
I
was
told you
voice.
Before. How many times I'd have to tell his character it's my real voice? If I you put just... on the funny voice for the TV, all go, go, go. As soon as I get in the motor, slip it into first. So... Fucking hell.
What did you write? You put the...
We put Expendables, and we didn't really know which one either. We guessed 3.
You guessed 3? Which one have you gone for? Kevin, Mo?
We didn't have a clue, so I thought it looks like an EastEnders Christmas special with Max Brannan.
It was Expendables 4.
No!
Yeah. Expendables 4.
No, we wasn't going
to
get that.
Points to Richard Bell. Let's take a look at Jason Statham in Expendables 4 in the original action-packed scene. Here we go. Here he is. You can sort of see... Yeah. OK. Now, the last one, I should warn you, if you're of a delicate disposition, might be an idea to go and make a cup of tea. This is going to be quite distressing. Take a look.
So if you could call me back today, that'll be great.
What are you doing?
Oh, shit.
Yeah.
Jimmy, you look like Amanda Holden there.
OK, so what have you got?
It's a backward E in the middle.
Oh, yeah. Hey.
No.
It's Megan with a backward E.
Yeah. Megan with the backward E. Rosie, Catherine?
Megan.
With a backward 3.
E.
And Mo, Kevin?
Megan.
Well, take a look at the less terrifying killer doll, Megan, the original. Pretty terrifying. let's see what that's done to the scores. I can tell you that currently in last place, Rosie and Catherine with 9. Just ahead, Mo and Kevin with 10. Way out in front, Richard and Mel with 15.
Yeah. Wow.
That is it for this part, but don't go anywhere because it's all to play for. To quote the last words of the captain of the Titan submarine, the pressure's on. See you in 5. Welcome back to the Big Fat Quiz. This next round is all about science and technology. In July, the new social media app Threads launched. Threads offered a brand new way for people all over the world to call each other Nazis and snowflakes. There were hopes Threads would become part of our everyday language. And in a way, it has. As everyone said, I've just deleted Threads. In November, Collins Dictionary crowned AI as its word of the year. People are increasingly worried AI will destroy our civilization and enslave us all. Sad, really. China hasn't even had their go. OK, time for some more questions, this time from the world of science and technology. Question one, take a look at this clip from back in September. OK, all I want to know is, what scientific discovery is in the box?
Is that Paul Hollywood behind?
Yes.
Yeah, maybe it's a cronut.
Yeah.
All right, have a listen to this. Back in April, millions of Brits heard it, whilst others complained they didn't hear it. All I want to know is, what is it? All right, for our next question, it's over to the Vivian.
Hello, Jimmy. Now, I love it when one of my social media posts goes viral, but one person I didn't think would be the star of the internet this year was the Pope. An AI image of him went viral back in March and got everyone talking. But what was so remarkable about the picture?
OK, what was remarkable about an AI picture of the Pope?
Oh, shit. Sorry.
I know this one.
All right, here's an ex, formerly Twitter post from Liam Gallagher back in April, complaining about a new service on the social media app. Paying for blank blank just to prove how real you are is absurd, and you know what rhymes with absurd? Blank, I am he, as you are me, and we are all together. Stick a comma in there, Liam. Missing words, please.
Pictures.
Nice.
Me?
Next up, Mariam Mashiri is describing a scientific phenomenon on BBC News back in August. All I want to know is, what is she talking about?
That was the case last night as the rare astronomical event took place for the first time since 2009. I'm so sorry, and I have a picture to show you. It looked a little bit like this. There you go. Take care. See you in a minute.
The photo didn't cue, so she said, what? It looked a bit like this.
She's left herself wide open for a crude Photoshop there, hasn't she?
That is some incredible girth you're working with there, Kevin. That is... You've got nothing to be ashamed of. Here we go. You all got the answers? I asked you what was in the box. What did you all put?
Felt like it was a new snake discovery.
A new snakey!
It's not a new snake, no. What have you got, Richard? Mel?
I think it might be a printer.
What?
A new voice box for Jason Statham.
Because he's working it very hard.
Mo, Kevin, what did you write?
Isn't this an alien? They found an alien, an ancient alien or something like that.
That is the right answer. It was reportedly an alien's body. Let's have a look. Yeah.
No. That really
That's not a fucking alien, man. That's the stuff you get at an arts and crafts shop that then people were coming at.
Yeah. Jaime Musan, a Mexican journalist and longtime UFO enthusiast, presented the remains to Mexican lawmakers. I don't know what laws they were going to make about that.
Why has it got a mobile phone?
All right. I asked you what this sound was.
Oh. Was it some kind of warning? Like a test
I think it went off on everyone's phone, like a natural disaster.
Aye, this is like Last Orders, the world's fucked. This is the sound you're going to hear, everybody.
I love the idea that Last Orders is how you would describe it. Was the emergency alert.
Mm. Yeah.
What did you guys get? Catherine, Rosie, did you get this?
Yeah, it was an emergency warning on your phone, and we received a text warning us that it would happen, and then some people panicked because they did not get the alarm, and I'm one of those people that just didn't go off. No Last Orders for me. They're like, she'll be all right. She'll figure it out.
Yeah. Richard, Mel?
Mobile phone terrorist alert.
Yes.
Well, yeah. I mean, that's it. Life-threatening situations, floods or terror attacks.
Yeah.
That was a warning. OK, well, points.
Great.
I don't know. The Vivian asked you why an AI-created image of the Pope caused a stir. What have you got?
I think that he had a hoodie or a face tattoo. It wasn't the Pope as we're used to seeing him.
OK, so the Pope, but he was wearing... What do you put? A hoodie.
It was a kind of Brian Harvey thing, wasn't it?
Yeah.
It was a white puffer.
East 17, kind of
white puffer, Brian puffer. Harvey thing. He was accept those. Jacket. That's the right answer. That's the right answer. Have a look at what AI did.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I want that.
That looks good. Looks like he's ready for Top Boy. Summer House's finest.
You were right. Yeah, it was the Pope in a puffer.
Cool.
I asked you to fill in the blanks on the Liam Gallagher post. What did you reckon?
When Twitter changed to like X or whatever, he had to pay for a blue tick. Maybe that says blue tick.
Okay, so blue tick, and then the third one?
Absurd rhymes with, I'm going to guess, turd. I don't know the, I'm guessing.
It sounds great in your voice, though.
Turd, absurd.
Yeah. It's exactly the right answer. Did you get this, Rosie Catherine?
Yes, we did.
Blue tick turd.
Are you calling me a blue tick turd? Fair enough.
Yeah.
Richard, Mel?
Fibre optic broadband. When speeds are already fine. Can I just say, we also put blue tick
put
after
blue
our
tick.
Silly answer.
Yes.
We put blue tick.
Yeah.
And did you put turd or...?
No.
OK.
Does anybody actually still say X?
No.
No-one has ever said
I don't think anybody ever... I still think it's hard to call Prince Charles the king.
Yeah.
I mean, I still see him as Prince Charles. I think he's just...
I have that with marathon and Snickers. For me, it's always a marathon.
Yeah. It'll never be Sif, it'll always be Jif.
Exactly. What about blooming opal fruits that now call themselves...
Starbucks.
Yeah, that's... Exactly. Whatever it is.
Yes, it was, of course, blue ticks and turd. Lovely. And finally, I asked you what the BBC news host was describing when she did this. What do you think?
We've gone with lunar eclipse.
Lunar eclipse. What have you gone for, Richard, Mel?
Jason Statham's testicle.
Just one of them.
The other one goes in the sidecar.
Mo, Kevin, what have you got for this?
There was like a supermoon, but apparently one of them was blue.
Oh yeah.
And it was it happened twice, quite close together.
Yeah.
So that expression "once in a blue moon" is a lot more kind of frequent than you'd actually think.
It was the closest full moon of the year, a blue supermoon. The next one won't be till 2037.
Wow. So that's not that long for that expression.
Yeah.
So that's got to be terminated then. Once in a blue moon means every 14 years. Like, Jimmy files his tax return once in a blue moon.
Yeah. OK, it's time for I Say What You See now. All I want to know is what headline do these images represent? Don't say it out loud. Mel, I'm talking to you. It's a headline from this year.
Yes!
I'm hungry.
OK.
Daddy's hungry.
Yes, please. Thank you, Rosie. Thanks, my love.
Oh, thank you.
Lovely.
Yeah, baby!
OK. Have you all got something down?
Yes.
Kevin, Mo, what have you gone for?
So it's bedbugs.
Infestation. Bedbugs infestation.
Yeah.
And then...
In
Paris.
In Paris.
OK.
Sparkler frying pan, Nick Knowles.
Sparkler frying pan, Nick Knowles. Rosie, Catherine?
Bedbugs infestation. Spark panic.
Fuck.
We were too focused.
Fuck, man.
It's a box panic. Richard, did you get this?
Bedbug infestation sparks panic in Paris.
Oh, thank you.
So, at the end of that round, the scores are... Let's have a look. OK, so still in last place, Rosie and Catherine with 13 points. Just ahead, Mo and Kevin with 16. In the lead, Richard and Mel with 19. Well, that's it for this part. There's no cause for concern. The alarm is for us. It's just telling us that it's time to top up Catherine's Botox. See you in a bit. Welcome Welcome back to the Big Fat Quiz of the Year. We're asking all the big questions, but in a fun, wasn't that a silly thing kind of a way, rather than a where were you on the night of the murder kind of a way. In our next round, it's all about people. Nigel Farage's bank account was shut by Coutts because of his views. Well, if banks are going to start closing people's accounts because they said something controversial, then I'm going to have to start keeping my money under my mattress. I say start. Will Smith's wife revealed that they've been separated for 7 years. Now, I wouldn't normally refer to her as Will Smith's wife, but apparently I have to keep her name, and I quote, out of my fucking mouth. In June, Sir Elton John headlined Glastonbury. Elton is now 76, which means these days when he shouts, I'm still standing, it's because he wants you to give up your seat. In February, Nicola Sturgeon stood down, or stood up, hard to tell. She's the size of Mrs. fucking Pepper Pot. All right, time for some questions. For your first question, it's over to Big Brother hosts AJ Adudu and Will Best.
Hi, Jimmy. Big Brother was back with a bang this year, and as always, it's been a blast. But being on TV every night, we don't half get through some outfits.
Too right. But our outfits don't make the headlines like Sam Smith's do. Back in February, they arrived at the Brit Awards and became an immediate talking point.
But can your teams remember what they were wearing?
OK, so they want to know what headline-grabbing outfit Sam Smith wore to the Brits.
Yes.
Yeah.
It was pretty memorable. In November, Harry Styles made headlines just by being at a U2 gig in Vegas. Why?
Why would he go to a U2 concert?
Because he likes U2.
But why would you like U2?
Elon Musk joined Joe Rogan on his podcast back in October, but what was he talking about in this revealing clip?
How much time did you need to prepare?
I don't need any time.
No time at all?
No.
How's your cardio?
That will not be a factor.
Really?
Yeah. Very I mean...
What's the likelihood of this actually happening?
I'm willing to do it anytime, anywhere, any place, any rules.
Well, I think this stating it this way might accelerate this process, great, especially on this platform.
I mean, I challenge him to a duel under any circumstances.
Oh, yeah.
Okay, so Elon Musk there unashamedly bragging about his cardio. What is he talking about?
You're right.
It sounds good. All right. Ex-footballer turned pundit Gary Neville went viral on social media for the surprising term he gives to 3, 4, or 5 day trips away. What term did he use? So Gary Neville went viral for describing 3, 4, 5 day trips away as what?
How do you know that?
Break up then, very clever.
Now, for the last question in this round, esteemed actor Charles Dance is reading an extract from an autobiography released this year. All I want to know is, who is the mystery author?
My penis was oscillating between extremely sensitive and borderline traumatized. I'd been trying some home remedies, including one recommended by a friend. She'd urged me to apply Elizabeth Arden cream. My mum used that on her lips. You want me to put that on my todger? I found a tube, and the minute I opened it, the smell transported me through time. I felt as if my mother was right there in the room. Then I took a smidge and applied it down there. Weird. Really doesn't do the feeling justice.
That was very strong.
Yeah.
You then do 2 seasons of Game of Thrones without picking up some tricks.
Pretty terrific.
That was brilliant.
All right, answers. So we wanted to know what headline-grabbing outfit Sam Smith wore to the Brits. What did you put?
They had sort of an inflated limbs leather look. I don't know what one would call it, but they had this suit and it was puffed up and it was black.
Inflated limbs leather look.
Yeah.
I love them, but they did look like, you know, them inflatable chairs in the 90s.
Mel, Richard?
Inflatable black wings.
OK, did you get this?
It's a big inflatable black suit.
PVC black bubble suit thing.
I'd love to put it on and just jump right into a swimming pool. Quite relaxing, isn't it?
Yeah, let's have a look.
That's a spy balloon, isn't it?
Points all round. OK, I asked you why Harry Styles made headlines around the world for being in the audience at a U2 gig in Vegas. What do you think?
He farted on the count of three.
That reeked. That reeked.
OK, Rosie, Catherine, did you get this?
We were not sure. I think Harry Styles would make headlines no matter what. We imagined Vegas, come off the red eye, maybe he fell asleep in the gig.
Okay. What do you, Mo? Kevin?
Did he shave his head?
He definitely did a skinhead at some point in the last couple of years.
That's the right answer. He went full Kevin Bridges. Take a look.
Oh wow.
Oh.
He shaved his head. I think he looks cool, but a lot of people, very unkind people online, said he looked a bit like Ian Beale.
What's wrong with that? What's wrong with that?
Yeah.
I wonder if Harry Styles touched his hair and he said, "I've got nothing left."
Well, he shaved his head, went to a U2 gig, and it made headlines around the world. God love him. All right. Elon Musk joined Joe Rogan on his podcast back in October. What was he talking about?
I think he was challenging Mark Zuckerberg to a nerd fight. He was definitely challenging someone to a fight.
That's the right answer.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah.
But as he could also be talking about playing one murder with you.
Yeah.
Richard, Mel.
I put he was going to climb inside himself, which I'd say it's a... I would like to see that.
OK. So, what did you guys get for this, Mo, Kevin?
You can read me.
Not from... Not from here, I can't. A bare bum boxing match with Jimmy Carr. A bare bum boxing match. Yeah, it was. He was talking about a rumoured cage fight against tech rival Mark Zuckerberg. They talked about the venue. There's rumours online he's been talking to the Italian Minister of Culture about the Colosseum in Rome as a possible venue.
But hangers, for the audience to watch it, something needs to be on the line other than just two bald billionaires. But put winner takes it all, not winner takes. SpaceX, absolutely
everything, yeah. All right, OK, so I wanted to know what term Gary Neville used to describe trips away. What did you put?
We didn't know this one. We had no idea. You just put lads on tour. We didn't know what
lads
to
on tour. That's a fair enough guess. Richard, Mel?
Mini retirements, I think he said.
Rosie?
Mini retirements.
He did. He described what you and I might call holidays as mini retirements. Let's take a look at the unique description in this revealing clip of Diary of a CEO.
You can never really retire if you love work and you are relentless. But what you can have is mini retirements during the year, and that's what I've tried to do. I don't do it very well. So, for instance, this weekend, I'm going to Spain Friday till Monday morning. I call that's like a mini retirement. So
that's a weekend.
It's a weekend. It's a mini retirement. It's where I basically can say for 3 days, I'm there and I'm basically taking, you know, I don't think about work. Now I will, but...
It's an argument for saying that some thoughts shouldn't be recorded. Which I think podcasting has challenged.
Charles Dance read from an autobiography. Who was the author? Book of the year, I'd say.
Yep.
What do you think, Mel?
Prince Harry Spare.
Prince Harry Spare. Catherine
Harry!
Rose. OK, Mo, Kevin?
We had Harry
he's
as well.
He's no longer a prince, eh? We just put Harry. Is he still known as Prince Harry?
He's not a prince no more.
Well, he is still a prince, but it's...
He's having a mini retirement.
Let's go back to Charles Dance, the one and only, for the answer.
That was Spare by Prince Harry.
Time for a special guest now, known for putting the cha-cha-cha into Channel 4 News. It's everyone's favourite, Krishnan Gurumurthy. Dance, baby, dance. Oh, yeah, please. Thank you very much. I mean, you're looking fabulous. It's very nice to have you on the show. Krishnan Gurumurthy, everyone, give him a round of applause. Thank you.
For real.
Very nice to see you.
Thank
how
you.
How was Strictly?
It was life-changing and wonderful.
Okay, and you have a question for us, I believe.
I do. Well, I suppose normally when I'm not dancing, I'm known for harder questions. But one of the biggest TikTok trends of this year involved husbands, boyfriends, fathers and brothers being asked a simple question about history. Mm. What was the question?
Yeah. Mm.
And all that's me.
Okay, I think they maybe know this.
I know, right? Okay,
so, now, you opted not to leave your wife during Strictly. That seemed like an odd choice.
Yeah, it was...
Oh, my God.
That show is losing its edge.
Yes.
Can I ask you a question?
Yeah.
When the news is finished, yeah? When you do this thing with the papers, why do you do this? Like, you look, finish the news and you... Is there anything actually on? I've always wanted to
it's
know this
It's a very
question.
Good question.
I swear on my life.
There's nothing actually happening. There is scripts on the papers, but we don't read the scripts.
Oh, well, I never knew that.
OK, did you all get this one? Let's have a look. Let's see if they got it. Richard, Mel, let's go to you.
Hmm.
Can you name any woman from the past?
It was something like that.
Something like that, OK. So close. Mo, Kevin?
Got it exactly, I think. How often do you think about the Roman Empire?
Catherine, Rosie?
Yeah, we've got the same.
Yeah.
OK, what's the answer?
The answer was, how often do you think about the Roman Empire?
Yeah.
The right answer? Yes, yes, yes.
Yeah.
It'd be crazy not to ask, how often do you think about the Roman Empire?
Apparently it's like every day or something mad, isn't it? That was like, men were saying they thought about the Roman Empire all the time.
Why?
And it was very surprising.
But let's get to the scores. OK, it's still in last place. Rosie and Catherine with 18 points. Mo and Kevin just ahead with 20. Just ahead of them, Richard and Mel with 22. Oh, well, that's it for this part. I'm off for a mini retirement, but give it up for Christian Gurumurthy. Yay! Welcome back to the Big Fat Quiz of the Year, the show that tries to jog more memories than the staff at a care home. This next round is all about sport. Taylor Swift began dating NFL star Travis Kelce this year. Kelce is considered one of the greatest tight ends of all time, as is Taylor Swift. In October, American rapper 50 Cent sponsored a Welsh under-14 girls football team. And if you're playing along at home, the answer is C, way too much marijuana. In March, Gary Lineker was suspended by the BBC for criticising the government's immigration policy. Lineker says he should be allowed to voice his opinion. That's all very well. I don't remember Gary speaking up when Walkers changed cheese and onion packs to blue and salt and vinegar to green. It's madness, Gary. Take a stand.
Whoa, what kind of way is that to break it to Mel?
Thank you, Kevin. Thank you.
OK, time for some questions. First sports question, over to footballing legend, Micah Richards.
Hi, Jimmy. Back in my playing days, I had a number of big physical clashes, and even now, we have a few in the studio. But can your teams tell me which sporting clash this year was described by viewers as the cuddle battle and the hugging match, featuring a reported 76 hugs in total?
76.
Hugs.
Oh.
Yeah, so... What sporting clash of the year was described as the cuddle battle and the hugging match?
Hang on, are salt and vinegars blue or...?
No. It's going to take so
well,
long...
Well, salt and vinegar... Christ.
Well, no, come back. I was very worried that this was going to happen.
I need some...
Yeah, they've changed it unilaterally.
Very little left.
Maybe you should be the new Doctor Who, but, like, real, real confused. All right, so, after Team Europe's Ryder Cup victory back in October, golfer Victor Hovland posed with his fellow teammates' wives and girlfriends for this picture. Can you tell me why?
Kind of creepy.
Golfers have a type, don't they?
They really do, yeah. During Wimbledon back in July, the umpire had to issue a warning to the crowd mid-match, which commentators described as the most Wimbledon warning ever. What was it? So it was the most Wimbledon warning ever.
Yes.
Was it he was going to fart in 3 seconds?
Have a listen to this rousing rendition of the national anthem from the British Grand Prix back in July.
Long to reign over us, God save the King.
It's God save the King. Sorry, Richard, you're going to have to explain to Mel the Queen's gone. OK, all I want to know is who's singing.
Yeah.
Oh, my gosh. All right. Yeah. David Beckham released a Netflix documentary this year in which he showed off his beekeeping skills. He wanted to call his honey Golden Bees, but Victoria had a better idea. What name did she come up with?
I've only seen the clip of him talking about his cupboard.
Oh, I love him. Wait. Yeah, the cupboard bit was great.
Wait, guys. Here's all my socks and all the pants and
another impression here.
I can do David Beckham.
He's got Statham. Yeah. That's nailed. We've done that. And now he's got DV.
Obviously, he's all my polo shirts in a row.
That's strong.
He's in many ways even more nasal than me, which is an achievement, especially at that level.
Right, time for some answers. Micah Richards asked you what big sporting clash was described as the hugging match. What did you put?
We thought it was a little boxy match between Tommy Fury and KSI.
Is exactly the right answer.
Oh.
Yeah, there they are. Having a lovely little hug. Mo and Kevin, I think you've pretty much got this, haven't you?
It's a half point, isn't it? We forgot the guy's name. Tommy Fury, and we knew it was some, as we wrote, some YouTube asshole.
Well, you don't know KSI's name.
Well, Kevin thought it was AJ.
I just knew it was one of that kind of mob.
I thought it was KSI or Tommy Fury.
I met KSI on your show.
I know, it's awkward because I know him too, but I didn't know. I didn't know. I didn't write it.
It was me.
I didn't write it.
You are like on this show.
I feel like I'm in fucking court. This is stressful.
What did you write?
We got the sport right.
Boxing.
AKA boxing. We got the personnel wrong, AKA Anthony Joshua.
Oh.
All right, so points there to Catherine and Rosie. Next up, I wanted to know why golfer Victor Hovland was posing with his teammates' wives and girlfriends. What did you all think?
We went for a won the John Terry Invitational.
That's very good.
I play golf. I actually, and I used to play a lot more. I had a golfing tutor, and it was so lovely, but he had to let me go because I genuinely kept falling over in the bunker.
And that's considered bad form?
Apparently, I was cool because I could get the ball out the bunker, but then I was stuck.
What's your answer on this? What did you actually write?
I've learned from previous questions that sometimes I'm too specific. So at first I guessed his partner's giving birth. And then I thought, well, maybe she's just not there. And then I thought, maybe he's single. And this is an advert. Do you look like this? Are you a Hawaiian Tropics model?
That is the answer.
Oh!
It was because he was the only single player on the whole team. Mel, Richard, did you get this?
We just put power and generic creepiness.
Power, and you think he posed like that because of power?
And generic creepiness.
OK, good answer. All right, so, Catherine, Rosie, you can have a point there. That's pretty close.
Right.
They're way behind. OK. I wanted to know what was described as the most Wimbledon warning ever. What have you got?
Don't pop champagne.
It startles them.
OK. Mo, Kevin, what did you go for?
The same thing. Popping during the Pwyll services, there were somebody popped a champagne cork and they had to announce it. Don't do that.
Richard, Mel.
Yeah, the same thing.
Stop popping champagne corks.
From their anuses.
I can tell you, the umpire told the crowd to refrain from opening champagne during serves. I asked you who was singing the national anthem terribly. Who do you think it was?
Mel knew. Damien Lewis.
Rosie, Catherine, did you get this?
Rosie also knew it.
Jamie and Lewis, but we also wanted to clarify that he is ginger.
You heard it here first. Mo, Kevin, did you get this?
We didn't get it. We just wrote Ian Beale, so... we didn't get this one.
It's going to be tough to get through this, everyone. We're in it together. Let's have a watch.
Okay.
It's unique and frankly awful. The national anthem, everyone.
God save our gracious King. Long live our noble King. God save the King. Send him victorious, happy and glorious.
So, just a moment's silence. The day the music died.
He should have been made to stay on the track for the whole race.
It's the earnestness.
Yeah.
Because you could have a laugh with it and be just fine, but it's how, like, before he even opens his mouth, it's the earnestness that is slamming my vagina shut.
Yeah. All right. I asked you what Victoria Beckham suggested David should call his honey. What did you all think?
We went with two become one, but for an extra point, we gave you an old school S that you do in school, so if we can get a point for that.
You thought that maybe would add value?
Yeah, for male, man. You know, throwback.
OK, Rosie, Catherine?
Well, I remember this because I agree. Victoria's really funny in that, Doc.
Yes, she's hilarious.
She is. And she's come up with DB's sticky stuff.
I knew it was something like that.
Yeah, DB's sticky stuff is the right answer. I presume you got it, Richard. Mel?
Yes, although we put sticky bits at
well,
the end.
Well, you say we.
OK, so we're saying no point, point, no point.
Boy.
Oh, come on.
Hey, I don't make the rules.
Jim,
I'm joking. I do. Let's have a look and see what that's done to the scores. OK, although it couldn't be closer. Mo, Kevin, you're now in last place with 21.
Oh, shit.
OK, Rosie, Catherine, you've got 23. In the lead still, Richard and Mel with 24. We're going to take a quick break now, but you have to promise you'll come back. It's the same system as prison day release. See you in five. Welcome back to the final part of the Big Fat Quiz of the year, and it couldn't be more exciting. Trust me, we've tried everything, and this is as exciting as it gets. The next round is all about the year's water cooler moments. In May, Liverpool hosted Eurovision. Originally, the contest was supposed to take place in Ukraine, but was moved to Liverpool due to the war. With destroyed buildings, a lack of basic sanitation, and violence erupting on every street corner... You can finish that joke yourselves, can't you? In May, Greggs won a battle with Westminster Council to sell sausage rolls in Leicester Square until 2 a.m. The big question now, where are Greggs going to find a gourmet chef to work that late into the night? In February, Lilt changed its name to Fanta, Pineapple and Grapefruit.
What?
Yeah.
Mel.
Jimmy.
Drips
and drabs, Jimmy. Drips and drabs.
Give me some warning.
It brought the entire nation together to say, wait, Lilt was pineapple and grapefruit flavour? Lilt had been accused of cultural appropriation, you know, using Jamaican stereotypes and ting. All right, time for the last set of questions, everyone. It's very close. All right, for the first question of this round, it's over to Loki star Sophia Domatino.
Hi, Jimmy. In Loki, my character Sylvie travels through time, embracing changing fashions along the way. She even gets a mullet. But a fashion trend from this year reminded people of Astro Boy, Ronald McDonald, and Dora the Explorer's best friend. Can your teams tell me what the trend was?
So, Sophia wants to know what fashion trend reminded people of Astro Boy, Ronald McDonald, and Dora the Explorer's best friend. Yeah. All right. Back in October, legendary thespian Brian Blessed made this statement. It's not dead, it will survive, and it will be very bushy. What was he talking about? Mel? That's a very smutty thought.
OK. In September, reports of a flood in the town of Lavira in Portugal had people on social media saying, I'd be on the ground, mouth open, I'd be running with buckets, and Jesus taking it to the next level. Why?
I like the way we've gone silent and focused and into some good, hard quizzing.
Yeah.
Yeah. I'm liking this.
It's our last chance.
Thank you, detective. Yeah. OK, at a Blink 182 show back in June, Kourtney Kardashian announced some big news to her husband, drummer Travis Barker, by holding up a sign in front of the crowd. You all have blank versions of the card under your desk. All I want you to do is write down what her card said.
I got a tattoo.
In October, Suella Braverman apologised to all dogs out there. What had she done? In October, Suella Braverman apologised to all dogs out there. What had she done? OK, you ready for answers?
Yep.
All right. First up, what fashion trend reminded people of Astro Boy, Ronald McDonald and Dora the Explorer's best friend? What do you think?
That was the big red boots.
Damn.
The big red boots?
How does Mo Gilligan know that?
OK, Catherine, Rosie?
Big red boots!
And did you get this, Mel?
We put knee-high boots.
Did you say red?
Yes.
Yeah.
OK, it was the fashion brand Mischief released their big red boots. I'll model them for you. Ooh. These are the big red boots. Wow. And it's a strong look, isn't it?
I don't like how Snoopy's changed.
And those are the real boots?
Yeah, those are the real boots.
What are you going to do with them after the show? I'll buy them off you.
You'll buy them off me?
Yeah, I'll buy them off you. They're cold.
You can have them.
Oh, for free?
Yeah.
Oh, thanks, man.
You know.
It's called a tax write-off.
Yeah. Brian Blessed said it will survive and it will be very bushy. What did you put?
We just said Richard's hair. We didn't know what to do. I'm sorry, Richard.
No, it's fine. I'm used to being a punchline. I mean, not a good one, but...
Rosie, Catherine.
Without it was a second more trainer, Hadrian Shaw.
That is the right answer, yeah. Yeah. It's a sycamore gap tree felling, yeah. And you put, Richard Mel, you put what?
Yew tree.
Oh, no, that's a whole different thing.
I know.
I asked you why people on social media wanted to be a flood in Portugal. What did you put?
Wine.
We knew that it was a flood of spilled wine.
Did you know this, Mel?
Samesies.
Yeah.
Samesies. Mo?
We just put something broke. We never knew it was wine. We just put a vineyard slash brewery. Booze, anyway, was pouring everywhere.
Let's take a look.
Só pode ter sido ao mar. Foi ataque, reventou.
Yeah, 2.2 million litres of wine gushed down the streets. Lasted for about an hour.
Oh, well.
Oh, wow.
Does that, Jimmy, as a, would that affect the flavour of the wine?
No, they put it straight in a box at the end. It's fine. I asked you what Kourtney Kardashian wrote on her sign. Well, show me your signs, what you all put.
I think she put that she was... Pre-
Travis,
she went to his concert, held that up to tell him that that's how she broke it to him, that she was expecting their kid. So it clearly makes her fucking mental. But she never actually wrote that, but that was why the brackets were there.
Okay,
but she put, Travis, I'm pregnant, or something like, or you're going to be a dad.
I mean, that's... what have you got?
I'm pregnant!
Well, I'm not surprised in that dress. Yeah, what did you get?
Car is waiting at arrivals. It's just fun. Just fun.
Hey.
Just fun.
All right. Points.
It's just fun, Jimmy.
Right, so you know what? A lot of fun writing things on cards. Turns out.
But I do have to say that a lot of people were dubious of this announcement. They were like, why would she be showing and announcing to her husband, who sees her every single day, that she's pregnant? But what it actually was, and Mel will appreciate this, mm-hmm. is a throwback to an early noughties Blink 182 video where there is a random fan in the crowd holding up a sign that says, Travis, I'm pregnant. So that's what she's doing. Oh. She's like, she's doing a cute announcement for the world. It was for us, not for him.
I'm just going to erase that, man.
Nice, yeah. All right, I asked you why Suella Braverman made an apology to all dogs. What did you all think?
She let them out.
That's what I thought.
She stood in a guide dog. Yeah. Guide dog handed her his business card.
Catherine, Rosie.
Yeah, she stood on a blind person's dog because she's a dickhead.
OK, Richard Mell.
She stepped on the tail of a Labrador.
It would appear she stood
on
a
guide
dog's tail.
No.
Yeah,
that's fucking hell.
And that's a really poiky heel there, isn't it?
It's that's a kitten heel, and they hate kittens. OK, let's check the points. OK, so I can tell you, Mo, Kevin, you have 25 points. A tie in the lead, Richard Mell, Rosie, Catherine, you both got 28.
Oh.
It is, you could steal this. OK, it all comes down to this. The big question, and here to help me ask it, our very own Barbie and Ken, everyone.
Ooh.
I give it up for Love Island Games contestants Megan and Toby. Please, come on, guys.
Thank you.
Wowzers.
Right. Oh, you look terrific here. So you got the big question for us?
We do. We have the big question. So, Barbie was, of course, the biggest film of the year, but who was the most Googled person?
So, who was the most Googled person of the year?
Lovely.
Second question.
What was the most watched UK TV broadcast?
And the last question.
And the last question was, what was the most streamed song in the UK?
Most streamed song.
Most streamed song.
Song.
Yeah, I didn't watch Love Island Games. Did you two or not?
No.
No.
Why not? He's a lovely looking fella.
Honestly, Megan, why not?
Why not?
Don't put me on the spot like that.
He's got a love. You're literally on a spot. How was your time on Love Island Games?
Intense. There's blood, sweat, tears, more tears.
Blood, sweat, tears, more tears.
Yeah.
I think he's missing out a few bodily fluids there.
Did you go to Fiji for it?
Yeah.
That's so cool.
Yeah, that was sick.
Let's see what answers you've got. Okay, so. Most Googled person, Richard Mell, what did you get?
We put Taylor Swift.
Yes.
Rosie, Catherine?
We've also put Taylor Swift.
And Mo, Kevin?
Taylor Swift.
Megan, what's the right answer?
The most Googled person this year was Taylor Swift with over 28 million searches. Yeah.
5 points, 5 points, 5 points.
That's
crazy.
Okay.
That's crazy. How do you know that? I don't know.
Okay, so what are your answers on the next one? The most watched TV show?
Coronation.
Coronation!
We said the coronation.
Coronation, but...
OK.
The most watched UK TV broadcast was the coronation, watched by an average of 18 million people.
Wow.
Ooh, OK. OK, this is the most streamed song of the year. You've gone for, Richard. I suspect this was you.
Bear in mind, this is the only song that I know of that came out this year. Dua Lipa, the one that was in Barbie.
Dua Lipa, the one that was in Barbie, OK. And nice. You've gone for Mo, Kevin?
We went for One Last Hurrah on the Doja Cat. We actually...
And Rosie, Catherine, what do you think was the most streamed song?
Miley Flowers.
What is the correct answer?
And the most streamed song in the UK this year was Flowers by Miley Cyrus.
Give him the trophy! Give him the trophy! Give him the trophy! They've won! The final scores are Mo and Kevin have 35, Richard and Mel have 38. The winners, Rosie and Catherine with 43. You have won. That's it. A big thank you to our brilliant panel, special guests, and thanks for watching. I've been Jimmy Carr. This has been the Big Bang Quiz of the Year. Good night!